Hello and assalamu alaikum. I hope that all of my students will be doing great. This is lecture number 2 of renewable and alternative energy system, and I am Usman Javed. If you have any queries related to this course, you may contact me on my phone number or my email address or through MS Teams or whatever medium you may prefer. So let's start. In today's lecture, I will go through the different definitions of energy, different forms of energy, and energy units. I will also briefly discuss about the impact of energy consumption with respect to economic growth of a country. So first of all, let us discuss that what is energy. By definition, energy is the ability to perform work. There are different forms of energy, which include thermal energy, that is known as heat, the luminous intensity measured in the form that is light, and energy can also be stored in the form of height. These are different forms of energy and they have different units associated with them. The higher the energy consumption, the prosperous the current country is. That is a direct relationship between the energy consumption and the economic growth of the country, because higher industrialization and commercialization will lead to higher demand of manpower, and higher demand for manpower means that the employment rate will be increased, and when the employment rate is increased, the per capita income threshold also increases, which leads towards the higher consumption of energy. According to physics, the energy is a quantitative property that must be transferred to an object in order to perform work or to heat the object. Energy is a conserved quantity, and there is also a law of conservation of energy that states that energy can neither be destroyed nor be created, and it can only transform from one form to another, and the total energy inside this universe remains constant. QED. QED loosely means that which needs to be demonstrated, implies that, hence proving the proposed notion. If a country has a higher energy consumption, then it must be prosperous. The energy resources can be categorized in two forms, which are the renewable energy, including the solar power, the wind power, the tidal energy, and the other form is the non-renewable, which are fossil fuel based, and fossil fuels are limited quantity in Earth. This is the graph which indicates the relation of energy consumption and economic growth. It can be seen that the GDP is linearly proportional to the economic growth. It can be easily comprehended from this graph that higher GDP growth is directly proportional to the higher consumption of energy. Research has been performed on different sets of data sets for different countries, and their results reveal that among the energy exporters, there is a bidirectional causality between economic growth and the energy consumption in developed countries in both the short term and long run, while in the developing country, energy consumption simulates growth only in short run. The findings obtained for different countries indicate that there is a positive and statistically significant relationship between energy consumption and economic growth over the long term, such that energy consumption contributes more towards the economic growth as the import dependence of different countries decreases. Moreover, the effect of energy consumption on economic growth decreases as the income level of the country increases. This indicates that the effective and efficient use of energy is also as important as the energy consumption, which is regarded as an important indicator of economic development and economic growth. And now I will compare the renewable energies and the fossil fuel based energy resources. The renewable energy sources, or the green energy sources, are the sources, natural resources, which can replenish over time when we use them, either through a biological reproduction or naturally occurring process. Energy sources that can be replenished over and over again and they are never depleted include the examples of hydropower, in which we use to build dams, and the kinetic energy from water is used to move turbines in order to produce electricity. The other example is the solar energy, which can be used to derive Stirling engines, and also using solar panels, electricity can be produced using sunlight. Some other examples are the tidal energy and the geothermal energy, in which solar water geysers are used to turn turbines in order to produce electricity. Geothermal energy is a form of energy that is stored in the form of heat inside the earth's crust. The other example include the biomass that we use from plants, and the nuclear energy, which use fission reactions and fusion reactions to produce an immense amount of energy. These type of energy sources are usually converted into thermal energy or electricity so that some work can be used from these energy sources. The other form of energy is the fossil fuel based source. The natural resource of economic value that cannot be rapidly replaced by natural means on level equal to its consumption, because the formation of coal, oil, or natural gas usually takes billions of years in their formation. Water as a source has been used to produce electricity by building dams. The only convenient energy source that is considered to be somewhat green. The hydroelectric power or the hydro energy is classed as a renewable energy source due to the fact that it relies on Earth's natural water cycle. We build dam and in each monsoon and each rainy season, the dams fill up with water. The damming of water is one of the oldest form of renewable energy that is being harnessed by mankind. The hydro energy doesn't produce emission while in operation, but however, it affects the ecosystem and the local habitat. For instance, if we build a dam, the nearby habitat will be affected because of the rise in water level beneath the ground and will destroy its ecosystem. Now, I will discuss about the alternative energy resources and their definitions. Number one, the alternative energy source, the energy derived from the sources that do not use up natural resources or harm the environment. The second definition is that alternative energy sources which are not popularly used, as it is usually environmentally sound, such as solar energy or wind energy or any other form of energy which are opposed to fossil fuels, including the fuel cells which use hydrogen as a primary resource of fuel and produce a massive amount of energy. Number three, the fuel sources that are other than those derived from the fossil fuels, which typically used interchangeably used for renewable energy, which have the following examples, including the wind energy, which use windmill to generate electricity, the solar energy, which use the solar power to run the Stirling engines, or the solar panel to produce electricity. The other one is the biomass, which is burned to produce heat or thermal energy, and also it can be converted into methane, which in turn can be burned to produce electricity. The other ones are the wave energy and the tidal energy. The fourth definition of the alternative energy resources are the energy generated from the alternatives to the fossil fuels which do not need to be renewable. Now, I will discuss about the energy principle. Energy is the driving force of the universe. Energy is the quantitative property of a system, which can either be in the form of kinetic energy or potential energy or other forms of energy like thermal or heat energy. There are many types and forms of energy. One of the forms of energy can be converted to another form. The laws of thermodynamics govern how and why the energy is transferred before the different types of energy resources and their uses are discussed. It is important to understand a little about the basic laws of energy, that it neither can be created or destroyed, change, it can change from one form to another, and the third one is the total amount of energy in the universe remains the same. The three laws of thermodynamics, I'll give them a little, I will discuss them in detail. There are three laws of thermodynamics. The first law of thermodynamics is also known as the law of conservation of energy, which states that the total amount of energy in the whole universe is constant, which means that all the energy has to end up somewhere, either in its original form or in some different form. We can use this knowledge to determine the amount of energy in the system and the amount it has lost as heat, and the efficiency of the system is reduced because of the loss of energy. The second law of thermodynamics states that the disorder in the universe always increases. There is an example that whenever you clean your room, it has a tendency to become messy again. This is the result of the second law of thermodynamics. As the disorder in this universe increases and the energy is transformed into less usable form, thus the efficiency of any process will always be tend to less than 100%. The third law of thermodynamics tells us that the molecular movement stops at the temperature we call absolute zero or minus 273 degree centigrade. Since temperature is a measure of molecular movement, there can be no temperature lower than absolute zero. At this temperature, a perfect crystal has no order. When we put together all of these laws, it can be concluded that the concentrated energy supply must be used to accomplish useful work. Now, let us discuss about the different forms of energy. If we categorize the forms of energy in a broader picture, there are two main categories of energy. The first one is the potential energy, and the second one is the kinetic energy. The potential energy has four forms, and the first one is the chemical energy. The chemical energy is the energy stored in the bonds of chemical compounds like atoms and molecules. This energy is released when a chemical reaction takes place. Usually, once a chemical energy has been released from a substance, then that substance is transformed into a completely new substance. The second one is the mechanical energy. The mechanical energy is the sum of kinetic and the potential energy in an object that is used to do work. In other words, it is the energy in an object due to its motion or position or both. The third one is the nuclear energy. The nuclear energy comes from splitting atoms in a reactor to heat water into steam, turn a turbine and generate electricity. There are approximately 94 nuclear reactors in 28 states that generate approximately 20% of the nation's electricity, all without carbon emissions because the reactors use uranium and not the fossil fuel. The fourth one is the gravitational energy. The gravitational energy is a potential energy stored in an object based on its distance from the Earth. Potential energy is the energy that is stored in an object or a substance. Gravitational energy is the form of potential energy. The earth, the sun, the planets and the stars all produce significant amount of gravitational energy. Now let's move towards the second category, that is the kinetic energy, or it can be translated that the kinetic energy is the energy from moving body. The first one is the radiant energy. Radiant energy is the energy of electromagnetic waves. These waves can travel through space. Electromagnetic radiation is made up of tiny particles called photons. Think of them as little packets of energy. Light energy is a form of radiant energy and it is composed of little photons. It is a form of radiant energy that is visible to human eye. Other form of radiant energy might not be visible to human eye. For instance, X-rays and other medical related terms. The next one is the thermal energy, also called the heat energy. It is produced when a rise in temperature causes atoms and molecules to move faster and collide with each other. The energy that comes from the temperature of the heated substance is known as the thermal energy. The next one is the motion energy, also known as the mechanical energy. It is the energy that is stored in moving objects. As the object moves faster, more energy is stored in it. Motion energy is the sum of potential energy and the kinetic energy in an object that is used to do work. And the last one is the electrical energy. The electrical energy is the form of energy resulting from the flow of electric charge or electrons. Electrical energy can be used in different home appliances. It can be used to apply force on an object. In the case of electrical energy, the force of electrical attraction or repulsion between the charges contribute towards the flow of electrons, and hence the current is produced. Current is known as the motion of electrons, and using that current we turn our home appliances. Now let us come towards the energy classification. The energy can be classified in the following. Number one is the primary energy. The primary energy is found in nature that has not been subjected to human engineered conversion process, which include the energy contained in raw fuels like fossil fuels or coal. The primary energy does not need to be a renewable or a non-renewable form of energy. Now, there comes the secondary energy. The energy sources made from the other sources than the fossil fuel, like hydrogen and the electricity. The final energy are the energy sources produced from the primary or the secondary energy sources that is directly consumed by the end user. For instance, the electricity at your service main or the wood that you want to use in your house furnace for heating purposes. The final one is the useful energy that is available to the consumer after the conversion of its last stage. For instance, When you turn up a light bulb or heat from the electrical heater, that is the form of useful energy. I hope that this lecture has increased your knowledge and understanding about this course. You may ask questions in Q&A session or through WhatsApp, through my email or MS Teams or whatever medium you may prefer. Thank you.